Hi everyone, welcome. This is Gennady from Queen's Botanical Garden. I wanted to talk to you today a little bit about some plants. I even brought my little orchid here to be my company. Now you probably know that plants have many different parts, and I did a little sketch, nothing fancy, right here to take a look at them. So we have roots, and that's how the plant gets nutrients and water from the soil. There's the stem that brings all those things back up to the rest of the plant. Plants also have leaves, which collect the sunlight and the carbon dioxide from the air and make sugar. There's also a flower, which makes the seeds in the middle. Now, my orchid here is really easy to see all the part. It shows all the parts. So there's a root right here. There's the stem, the leaves, and even has the flower. It didn't make any seeds yet. Later on, would you show me your plants? Thank you. Okay, let me put that away for a second. Now, I was a little hungry earlier, and I went to my kitchen, and guess what? All I could see in my kitchen is plants. Did you find plants in your kitchen? No? Well, let's take a look. There are plants that you can find that have each one of these parts represented. So let's take a look what I have in my kitchen. Let's start with the roots. Has anyone ever seen one of these? A carrot? Yeah, a carrot is a root of a plant. This particular root stores food. And another one is the sweet potato. There we go. You can even see the little rootlet coming off of it in this case. This one started going bad a little bit. How about stems? Did anybody find any stems? Well, this is actually a cool one because it has both roots and the onion itself is a stem. I also have a garlic that does the same thing. It has roots right here, which is the part that we don't eat, and the little cloves, which we do eat. Those are the stems. Another stem you might be familiar with is the celery stalk. There we go. We have some stems. You can even see the little strings, the little veins inside that bring up the food. This is where the root would be, and you can see the beginnings of some leaves on this one. Now, some of the hardest time I had was looking for leaves in my kitchen. I did find some, however. I found this purple cabbage, which is made up of these beautiful purple leaves all wrapped together nice and tight. And I didn't find any lettuce or anything like that, which you might have in your kitchen, but I did find some bay leaves, which are a spice or an herb we use to flavor our food. So we got our roots, some stems, and some leaves. How about flowers? Flowers are a tough one, because usually I would show you some broccoli, but guess what? Had it for dinner last night, and I forgot to save any. Instead, I have for you guys, I know this looks kind of odd, but this is the flower bud of a plant that's kind of like a cousin of a sunflower. This is an artichoke. And if you keep peeling it open and open, you will find in the middle is where the flower starts and where the seeds would be made. Speaking of seeds, I did find some seeds in my cupboard, dried. I found some green peas and some lentils. Maybe we can make some dal later. I did also find some fresher ones. I found these string beans. Let me peel this one open so you can see the seeds inside. There we go. And some sweet peas. Oh, one of them. This is a fresh pea. So these are, you can eat fresh, or you can let them dry on the vine and then harden off. And that's what you can use for planting too. Delicious. We shouldn't be wasting that. All right. So those are the parts of the plant. Now, I did mention something else, that sometimes these plants, these seeds, are covered in a layer of yumminess. These look quite familiar to you all? An apple and a cucumber. Now, this is, we call this a vegetable and this is a fruit, but check this out. For a plant, I'm going to use this to cut our plant. These are the same because they are both the fruit part of the plant. And we know that because inside both of them, you can find little seeds. Next time we talk, I'm going to show you how to use the items in your kitchen to plant and grow real live seeds. Hope everybody had fun, and I'll see you next time.